Candy Bar, London's famous lesbian bar. Sitting in the heart of London Soho, hundreds of women hang out at this popular bar every week.
It's a whole new world.
Last week, bar manager Sam pulled rank with her staff.
I'm really fucked off.
Twin Natalie landed a top job.
I feel amazing. I've officially got a job.
And Sandra and her partner finally became mums.
He's just adorable.
Coming up, Jo Weber's dinner party gets personal.
Like, two women, just put it out for
you. They do.
Directionless Danny wets her palette.
I'm drawing naked women.
And a venue swap gets Sam in a strop.
I need someone who can melt chocolate and not fuck it up. No, it's not just put it in the microwave.
In Soho, unemployed arts graduate Danny is seeking inspiration, so she's decided to join an art class.
It's good because it just gets me out of the flat. I'm just really looking forward to it. I need to, you know, sort my life out a bit and get a fucking grip.
22-year-old directionless Danny moved back to London 8 months ago.
You know when you finish uni and you come to London and you go, OK, so I need a job? Well, where do you start?
Whilst trying to figure out her career path, Danny's done a lot of soul-searching, also known as partying, with the occasional job interview thrown in. She's tried modelling.
Don't feel that you're going to be quite strong enough for us at the moment.
That's a no. And she's tried pole dancing, but she's realised her real talent lies in art.
Yeah, you can be talented, but how do you know what direction and where to put your energy and, you know, where to start?
So where better to kickstart her art than an evening class?
And I don't mind if whatever I draw is shit either, because it's just about being here, like, by myself, doing something for me. That's the most important thing.
Run by illustrator Ben Van Howell, this challenging session certainly doesn't just mean drawing inanimate jugs.
Beautiful. That was great. How long can you handle it?
I don't know. We'll find out.
Hi, I'm Van. Nice instructing.
A fan of the female form, Danny quickly gets inspired.
Keep your pen or your charcoal or pencil or whatever it is moving. It's a nice upside down face.
This is my lying down woman and her ass. I'm not scared to make mistakes. I never said I could do it. But look, like, it's really fun. So, I love it. I'm very proud of myself.
But it's not just the model that's got Danny's creative juices flowing.
Well, she's going to move. I'm going to draw in colour.
For the final pose of the evening, Ben suffers for his art.
He wants to rest. We have a teacher down.
The teacher's on the floor. I think he's fainted.
How are we doing? Am I dead yet?
Stay there.
Pretty well. All right.
I was drawing you and then I just got there and you moved.
Okay. I guess that's about it. Well done, Alexis. This is the one that I like the best. The colors really work nicely.
It's just so nice to be around people, one with passion, two with knowledge, and three, like, just talking to you about it, you know? It was really inspiring.
But that's not the only thing that's aroused Danny's interest.
That's the idea, isn't it? She's hot. I noticed when I was talking to her, I was like doing this laugh. But I don't think she's gay, I'm not sure. My gaydar is... my signal's bad. All right,
nice
then.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Okay.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
She'll never know. Henshaw recently added the Candy Bar to his string of gay bars, but Monday night takings are a worry. As a result, Gary's called in manageress Sam for a chat.
I mean, I'm very happy the way things are going with the weekends. I'm still concerned about weeknights, so I think that's what we need to be concentrating on.
A successful entrepreneur, Gary hasn't got where he is today without shaking things up. Since taking over this lesbian mecca, he's tried a cocktail night, speed dating, and a highly successful anti-Valentine's night.
We exceeded the target that we set ourselves, which is good.
Now he's looking to repeat this success on a Monday night.
Something that I thought might really appeal would be salsa dancing.
Yeah, I think that could work, actually.
I mean, when I think salsa, I think boy-girl. I mean, I mean, I can't really imagine even boy-boy or girl-girl, and I run a gay bar and lesbian bar.
I mean, salsa's quite a sexy dance, and, you know, if it's a woman-for-woman-only dancing thing, I think that could be quite interesting, actually.
If I asked you to try and arrange your salsa night starting Monday coming...
This Monday?
Yeah.
Like 3 days away.
Yeah. Do you think you'd be up for it?
Yeah, I think I could.
I mean, all we have to do is find a teacher, correct?
Yeah, pretty much. I think it's definitely doable.
I don't want the venue dead. I want the venue alive, and I've no doubt that we can get a group of people into the bar that wouldn't normally be there, and we can double, treble the revenue on Monday night.
I'm going to get a candy now and get on it, and I'll update you later.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thanks, Gary.
See you later.
I just have to pull it out the bag and just do it, because that's what Gary's put me in here for. He wants someone that can just do it when he says do it, so I'm going to jump to the challenge.
Coming up, Candy Bar's Salsa Night kicks off. And Shabby has a confidence crisis.
Why didn't you tell me?
Tell you what?
My hair looks like dog shit.
The renowned lesbian haunt, the Candy Bar, the new management are trying to reinvent Mondays with salsa nights. Supervisor Alex has noticed a difference since the takeover.
We never used to try things because they used to go, oh, just, it won't work, but at least they're giving things a go.
But a tight turnaround is taking its toll on manageress Sam.
I actually can't deal with this anymore. I get stressed with the short-noticed ones because I like to plan and prepare. And it's difficult to do that when something gets sprung on you last minute. Even when I do get stressed, and there are times when I do, everyone kind of pitches in and does what needs to get done. Right. I've pressed OK, like, how many times? Failed using default.
Happily, Candy Girls Alex and Lizu have had more success. Upstairs, people are starting to arrive.
Hi there, good evening.
Including Stuart, highly accomplished supremo of same-sex salsa.
And recently I was in the gay games and came 12th in the world, which was a good achievement. And went away.
Candy Bar regular Natalie is a salsa virgin.
Any salsa experience? None. I have no salsa experience. I've never ever done it before in my life.
Sadly, it's not the best turnout.
Ladies and ladies, I'd like to introduce you to our salsa teacher this evening.
Right, we're going to go from the top then, nice and slow. And forward, backwards, close, and that's backward. Well done, yeah?
Yes, I can move my feet.
Yeah, so just take your partner for now. The followers go on top. Not underneath today, on top. step, close, and do a little...
It's good to see all the, like, personalities in the pairs. So you've got the really, like, fun, humorous, having a laugh.
And everyone's doing the same as us.
The other two that are, like, taking it quite seriously, but still having a laugh. And then the lovebirds, really trying and getting it and loving it.
It was a good laugh down there, and it seems that they've had a good night, so that's the main thing.
After we got into the right step, it ended up being really fun, and
Yeah, I learned a few moves. It was good.
Hey, we all need to learn a few moves. Brilliant.
Salsa was fun, but I'm absolutely shit.
And sadly, so were tonight's takings. But Sam's undeterred.
It was a little bit short notice. So obviously getting the press out there to people was a little bit more difficult than normal. And I just think if we do advanced advertising, I think we could definitely bring the girls in.
In East London, Roxanne is in a cleaning frenzy. Her girlfriend Rachel is due back from Brazil in a couple of hours.
Just manically trying to tidy the flat because Rach is due in at the airport in a couple of hours and I've kind of left it the last minute, so now I have to wrap the present, clean the flat, do it all before she gets here because she won't be happy if it's the state when she gets back. So trust me to leave it to the last day, but there we go.
Rach and Rox met at university, and there's some dispute as to who seduced who.
We just had a night out, just me and her, and drank quite a lot of alcohol.
I think I was probably subconsciously aware that something might happen, because I was going to start it.
And then, like the predator, she pounced, and I was helpless to her charm.
Yeah, I think she kissed me, and then I kind of took things a bit further.
5 years on, this is the longest they've spent apart since they set up home together.
Missing Rachel a lot. It's been very weird in the flat without her because it's the first time since we moved in together that she's been away. She'll come back with a nice tan, so we'll both benefit from that. She told me if I cleaned the toilet, she would consider that real love, but apparently it's not because I can't bring myself to clean the toilet.
Keen to be in position when Rachel arrives, Rox has allowed plenty of time. In fact, there's even time to make a sign. Ah.
I'm sure she'll be the last one out. Can't be long now. These people must be off the same flight, so. I was still excited, but I wish she'd just turn up because I've been waiting ages.
And then the moment Rox has been waiting and waiting for.
Okay, baby.
Yeah, you took so fucking long. I'm gonna kill you, Ovid.
Hey.
You look brown.
You smell lovely.
Thanks.
You've had a haircut.
Maybe.
Ooh. I like my little zone.
I know. Honestly, I was gonna screw it up and eat it.
You took so long.
Everyone has gone. You're the last person.
You look lovely.
So do you.
It was Rachel's birthday whilst away, so for her, there's an added bonus to coming home.
You remembered it's your presents today?
Yeah, I know.
There is a little surprise in there somewhere.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
I have to wait and see.
Is it a piece of jewellery?
I can't say.
Better not be.
Better not be what?
It's popped at the tyre, didn't it? What was that? Can you open the window? Maybe
we're hot. Having left the cleaning to the last minute, will Rox's efforts meet Rachel's high standards?
Wow. I'm impressed.
It's all right, isn't it?
You're doing all right.
Oh, is it not quite...
It's not quite straight.
I was in such a rush doing it.
Oh, baby, I'm joking. Thank you.
Rox got brownie points for the cleaning.
Thanks.
So is her belated birthday gift the icing on the cake?
How long? I've got no idea.
I don't think it's a ring, not at all. We're so neither of us are there, and if it is, I've like completely ruined it.
We're going to New York.
When?
In June. That's what those days were.
You went time off work. Oh, my God, I thought...
I've got a hotel booked and everything, so...
Oh, baby.
That's awesome.
I love you.
I love you too.
The heart of trendy East London. And Jo Webber may be having to live with mum and dad, but at least she has a girlfriend to escape to.
So how does it feel to be back in Shoreditch? Oh, it's so nice. I mean, obviously.